latter see a problem on the determination of resident status of an individual. See this problem. Simon, an American, came to India on 20th December 2016 and he remained in India till 31st January 2018 when he went back to Canada. Again, he came to India on 20th May 2018 and thereafter he was sent to Japan for 6 months training on 1st November 2018. Next, he transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. You are asked to determine his residence status for the assessment year 2019-20 and assessment year 2020-21. First, we should find out the residence status for the assessment year 2020-21. Previous years relevant to the assessment year is 2019-20 and stay in India during the previous year 2019-20, that is from 1st April 2019 to 31st March 2020 is. He transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019, that means in the previous year 2019-20, and he was sent to Japan for 6 month training on 1st November 2018, that is in the previous year 2018-19, after the completion of his training for 6 months, he again came to India. He was sent to Japan for 6 months training on 1st November, November, December, January, February, March, April. That means on 1st May 2019, he came to India and thereafter he transferred to Singapore branch on 20th August 2019. That means during the previous year 2019-20, he was in India from 1st May 2019 to 20th August 2019. So, on 20th August 2019, he was transferred to Singapore branch. On 1st April 2019, he was not in India. He was in Japan in a train. So, now comes the number of days. May 31, June 30, July 31 and August 20. So totally 112 days. That is in May 31 days, June 30 days, July 31 and August 20. So during the previous year 2019-20, he was in India only for 112 days. That is, in order to become a resident, the first basic condition is that he was in India for a period or periods amounting in all to 182 days. So the first basic condition is not satisfied by him. Next, see the second basic condition, which is 365 days in 4 preceding previous years and 60 days in the relevant previous year. In the relevant previous year, he was in India for 112 days. Hence, there is a possibility of applying the second basic condition. Whether he is here in India during the 4 preceding previous years for 365 days or not. So, 4 preceding previous years relevant to the previous year 2019-20 or 2018-19, 2017-18, 2016-17 and 2015-16. Simon, an American, came to India on 20th December 2016, that means in the previous year 2016-17. Earlier to that, he was not in India. He was in America, 14-15, 2013-14, 2011-12, 2010-11, and 2009-10. So, during this period, he was not in India. He was an American citizen. Came to India for the first time on 20th December 2016. That means during the previous year, 2016-17. He was in India till 31st January 2018. Till 31st January 2018 means in the previous year 17-18. So he came to India during the previous year 16-17 and till 17-18 he was in India. Now during the previous 16-17 he came to India on 20th December 2016 and he was in India during that period up to 31st March 2017. And second, during the year 17-18, from 1st April 2017 to till 31st January 2018 and again he came to India on 20th May 2018. It was in the previous year 2018-19, 20th May 2018, and he was sent to Japan for 6 months training on 1st November 2018, that is 20th December 2018 to 1st November 2018 he was in India. Thereafterwards he came to India on 1st May 2019 after the completion of his training of 6 months. Now during the previous year 16-17 he was in India, that is in December 13 days, January and February and March, so totally 103 days. And during the previous year 17-18 he was in India, 17-18, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December plus January, he was in India. So number of days, three not 6 days during 17-18 he was in India for a period of 366 days. And during the previous year 18-19 he was in India from 20th May 2018 to 1st November 2018, that means in May 11 days, June 30, July 31, August 31 and September 30, October 31 and November 1, so total number of days 185 days. Now apply the second basic condition, which is during four preceding previous years he was in India for a period of 365 days or more and in the relevant period 60 days. 185 days, 306 days and 103 days. 18-19 he stayed in India for 185 days, 17-18 he was in India for 306 days and 16-17 he was in India for 103 days. So totally he was in India for 594 days during four preceding previous years. It is enough if he stays for 365 days in four preceding previous years and 60 days in the relevant previous years. Hence the basic condition number A not satisfied, B satisfied. A not satisfied because he stayed in India only for 112 days, and B condition That is 365 days in 4 preceding previous years plus 60 days in the relevant previous year is satisfied. Hence, he is become a resident. Mr. Simon, for the previous year 2019-20 relevant to the assessment year 2020-21, was a resident. If an individual becomes resident, next let us see whether he is a ordinary resident or not ordinary resident. In order to consider or determine the resident status, whether he is ordinary resident or not ordinary resident, we have to apply the additional conditions. Number one, he must be resident for 2 years out of 10 preceding previous years. And number two, he has been in India for a minimum period of 730 days in 7 preceding previous years. If both of these additional conditions are satisfied, in addition to satisfying the basic condition, he is called as ordinary resident. If one or none of the conditions are satisfied, then he is known as not ordinary resident. He must be resident for 2 years out of 10 preceding previous years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 18, 19, he was a resident because he stayed in India for 182 days. 17, 18, again, he was a resident because the first basic condition is satisfied. And during the period 16, 17, he was in India only for 103 days. And earlier 4 preceding previous years, he was not in India. Hence, for the previous year 16-17, he was a non-resident as he was not satisfying the basic conditions. Next, so during 10 preceding previous years, he was a resident for 2 years. The first additional condition is satisfied. And second additional condition, 730 days in 7 preceding previous years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. During 7 preceding previous years or totally, he was in India for 594 days. Hence, the second basic condition, additional condition, is not satisfied by him. So, Mr. Simon, for the previous year 2019-20 or for the assessment 2020-21, satisfies the basic condition itself. Only the basic condition is satisfied by Mr. Simon. Hence, he was a not ordinarily resident. If an individual satisfies only the basic conditions, not satisfying additional conditions, then he is not ordinarily resident. If an individual satisfies the basic condition and both of the additional conditions, then he is called as ordinarily resident. If an individual fails to satisfy the basic condition itself, then he is called as non-resident. So, for the previous year 2019-20 related to the assessment year 2020-21, Mr. Simon is not ordinarily resident. Not ordinarily resident. Next, for the assessment year 2019-20 relevant to the previous year 2018-19. Now, we see for the previous year 2018-19, what was he? For the previous year 2019-20, he was a not ordinary resident. For the previous year 2018-19, he was in India for 185 days. That means the first basic condition is satisfied to become a resident. Next, we can see whether he was an ordinary resident or not ordinary resident. So, out of 10 preceding previous years, he was a resident for 2 years. 18-19 is the present previous year. In preceding previous years, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that, 10 years. In this year, he was a resident, and 16-17, he was a non-resident as he was fails to satisfy the basic condition. Therefore, during 10 preceding previous years, he was in India only for, he was a resident only for 1 year. During 1819 previous year, relevant to the assessment year 2019-20, he was a resident only for 1 year, that is during the previous year 2017-18. The provision says that earlier 10 preceding previous years to the relevant previous year, he was he must be a resident for 2 years, but he was a resident for only 1 year and he was not in India for 730 days. Here also he satisfies only the basic condition to become a resident. Hence, for the previous year 2018-19, relevant to the assessment year 2019-20, he was called as resident, but again not ordinary resident. So in conclusion, for both the assessment years 2019-20 and 2020-21, he was a not ordinary resident. Now, while giving answers to this question, first write the previous year 2019-20, next number of days stayed in India and show the working notes. Next write the solution part, name of the assessee, Mr. Simon, previous year 2019-20, assessment year 2020-21 and residence status, name of the assessee, Mr. Simon, previous year 2018-19, assessment year 2019-20 and the residence status, not ordinary resident. Not ordinary resident. And give the explanation. During the previous year 2019-20, he was in India only for 112 days. The first basic condition is not satisfied by him. To become a resident, he must be in India for 365 days in 4 preceding previous years and 60 days in the relevant previous year. The second basic condition is satisfied by him, hence he become a resident. To become an ordinary resident, he has to satisfy both of the additional conditions specified under section 6, subsection 6. They are, he must be a resident for 2 years out of 10 preceding previous years and he must be in India for a minimum days of 730 days in 7 preceding previous years. Relevant to the previous year 2019-20, he satisfies one of the additional conditions. Therefore, he becomes a not ordinarily resident for the previous year 2019-20. And also again, the previous year 2018-19, name of the assessee Simon, previous year 2018-19, assessment year 2019-20 and the resident status not ordinarily resident. Again write the previous year 2018-19 and stay in previous year, that is from 20th May 2018 to 1st November 2018, 185 days. The first basic condition itself is satisfied by him to become a resident. And again, in the next para, you should write the conditions to become a ordinary resident. Two conditions, 2 years out of 10 preceding previous years and 730 days in 7 preceding previous years. None of the basic additional conditions are satisfied by him. So he satisfied only the basic conditions, hence he is a resident but not ordinary resident for the previous year 2018-19, relevant to the assessment year 2019-20 also.